Okay, welcome guys. In this session, basically we are going to review the questions of the June FMGE 2022. Now this is a mixed bag questions. What I am trying to explain you is the question that was asked from the QRS session that we had around 10 to 15 days back. So I will be showing the questions that came directly from the QRS session that we had at the Arise Medical Academy. The first question that was there was regarding the cardiac tamponade that was based on the back strat. That was a straightforward easy question. They have given the question, there was decrease in the blood pressure, the neck veins were filled, muffled heart sound. That was a very classical case. We have discussed almost the same case, and that was the cardiac tamponade. The second question was, you can see that is written is, there was in the question they have given not the ECG, but they have written no P wave, irregular ARR interval. The answer was atrial fibrillation. Again, it was a direct straightforward question from the QRS. Then the next question, there was slight confusion regarding the meningitis part. They have given the CSF analysis. Many of the students are saying that it was predominantly neutrophils. Many are saying predominantly lymphocytes. If it is in any of the case, we have discussed both the two. You can see in the green color that was the, if the neutrophils were there, it is bacterial meningitis. If it was lymphocyte, it was tubercular meningitis. The next thing was again a straightforward question from surgery, mouse in the breast, that is fibroadenoma. Then the next question was the iron chelator. If someone is having iron toxicity due to multiple transfusion or maybe taking iron folic acid for a long time, so the iron chelator has to be given, that is disferoxamine. Then the next question was from the Reynolds phenomena. Again, a direct question from the QRS, Reynolds phenomena. They asked that what is the treatment. They have given in the question the finger is turning white, the bluish, then red. They asked that what is the treatment that you are going to give. It is CCP. The next was the question from the heart failure. They asked the question in a way that there is a patient of heart failure. There are certain group of drugs that decreases the mortality. There are certain group that decreases the symptoms only. So we have discussed very clearly. You can see here, we have discussed very clearly. Mortality is decreased by ACE inhibitor, ARB, and ARNI and beta blocker. And they have given one of the example of ACE inhibitor, that was the lisinopril. Then there was a question from the pathology part, dystrophic calcification, the example of dystrophic calcification, and we have discussed that atherosclerosis is one of the example of the dystrophic calcification. Just below to that, we have discussed one more line. You can see here, the drug causing pulmonary fibrosis is the bleomycin and busulfan. One of the option was there, I think bleomycin was given in the choice, and that was the answer to that question. Just next to that, we have discussed about three main stains, and one of them was asked in your exam, the stain for the hemosiderin. It was pearls, prussian blue. Then just next line, you can see that, okay, here you can see that there are two times that happen in the QRS that two continuous questions were asked. We have discussed the hemosiderin. Just below that, we have discussed the cat scratch disease, and again that was asked in your exam this time. Both the questions were there. The causative agent for the cat scratch disease is the Bartonella Hansalli. Then from this diagram, there was a question from the pharmacology that they asked the mechanism of action. Some are saying for the mechanism of action of aspirin, or some are saying clopidogrel. Both are there. Aspirin is the antiplatelet drug. Clopidogrel, what happens in the clopidogrel is it is an ADP receptor inhibitor, P2Y12 inhibitor. So aspirin, if they have given the choice that aspirin belongs to which category, it is the antiplatelet group. Then there was a question from the Brown Sequard syndrome. They have given the image hemisection of the spinal cord, and they asked that which sensation will be lost on which side. In the QRS, we have discussed that the mnemonic is top, that top is temperature and the pain is going to be lost on the opposite side, TOP. So by that we have solved the question. The next they have asked is I have highlighted again in the yellow color that the most sensitive test that you will do in a case of iron deficiency anemia, it is the serum ferritin. They have given some language, they have given the clinical units, but that was the crux. If you know that statement, the answer was going to be correct for you. Then they are just below to that, again you can see that just we have discussed kiya tha ki iron deficiency anemia mein the most sensitive test that is to be done is serum ferritin. Uske just niche humne discuss kiya ki myasthenia gravis mein is which type of hypersensitivity is, it is type 2. Then there was a question from retinoblastoma. They have given that there is the white eye reflex, the white eye reflex that was there in the child. They have not given the image. We have discussed the image also, but they have not given the image. And the answer to that question was retinoblastoma. Then there was a question from bronchiectasis. So some are saying that they have given the CT scan, and some are saying they are given the X-ray. You can see that we have discussed the signet ring appearance, the tram track appearance in the CT scan. That is the copious sputum that the patient will have, and that is suggestive of the bronchiectasis. Then there was a question from lung cancer. Again, the question is not very clear, but they have asked that which is the most common cancer, right? So again, it will depend that what are the other things that they have given. They are asking for smoker, non-smoker. Smoker is going to be squamous cell. Non-smoker is going to be adenocarcinoma, and both we have discussed. Both we have discussed. Then there was a question from the X-ray they have given. There was the trachea was shifting towards the opposite side, and the absent, there was the breast sound was absent on one side. It was tension pneumothorax. There was a question from the Gilbert syndrome. We have discussed the congenital hyperbilirubinemias, and one of them was the Gilbert syndrome, where unconjugated bilirubin will be high, but the condition is not very severe. So it presents in the age group of 20 to 30s. There will be on and off jaundice will be there, and this is what they ask. Unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia is seen in which condition? It was Gilbert syndrome. We have discussed about schistosomiasis. There was a question on schistosomia, that schistosomia leads to which cancer? Schistosomia leads to urinary bladder cancer. It is the squamous cell type of urinary bladder cancer. Then there was a question from the Schimmer's test. They have not given the image of Schimmer's test. They have given the values that litmus paper is placed, and they have written that right eye 5 mm, left eye 10 mm, or maybe somewhat values were given. That was the test that is done for the dry eyes, and treatment for the dry eyes, you have to give the artificial tears or the lubricants. Then there was a question from this was the exit image that came. We have discussed in the QRS also the viral keratitis, that was the dendritic ulcer that we see. Then there was a question from the chalazion. There is a painless nodule. The image was not there, but they have given the scenario. There was a painless nodule on the upper eyelid. That is a case of chalazion. We have written all the things. You can see in the painless upper eyelid, it is chalazion. Then there was a question from the Waters view. I have not shown you the X-ray, but I have made the X-ray that there will be the mouth will be open in the Waters view. There was the X-ray was given, and they asked that what is the view. The mouth is open and the X-ray was done. It is the Waters view. It is done to see the maxillary sinus. Then there was a question from the Meniere's disease. Although it is somehow not a direct question, but you can see that I have written Tullio's phenomena, and I have explained you what is Tullio's phenomena, that whenever the patient will have the loud voice, whenever the patient will experience a loud voice, the patient will develop vertigo, tinnitus. That is called as the Tullio phenomena, right? So they have given in the question, mein bola tha ki jab bhi patient ko loud voice ka exposure hota hai, the patient gets symptomatic. The patient will have the tinnitus, will have the vertigo. That is a case of Meniere's disease. Then we have discussed about the nasopharyngioma. I told you that whenever there is cervical lymphadenopathy, if they say massive cervical lymphadenopathy, it is going towards the nasopharyngioma. It's going towards the nasopharyngioma. Although they have, the age group that they have given was the 60 year of. See, nasopharyngioma has we can say bipolar age group. Bachcho mein bhi ho sakta hai, or it can happen in the elderly. Then there was a in the question in the anesthesia, although the language is not very clearly framed by the question, but the question was ki jab hum elective surgery kar rahe to what should be the ideal thing to be said to the patient for NBM. I told you that the current guideline is NBM to prevent the kneel by mouth, to prevent the aspiration pneumonitis, is for solid, it is 6 hours. 6 hours prior to that, the patient should not eat anything. Then there was a question from the psoriasis. You can see at the top, I have written that if there is an infection in the psoriatic lesion, it is called as the gutted psoriasis. Or unhone image diya tha gutted psoriasis ka, back ka image tha, multiple patches thi, that was the image of the gutted psoriasis. Then we have discussed about the Cobner's phenomena. Although I have asked many of the students, but they were not able to tell the correct language of the question, but there was a question from Cobner's phenomena. Cobner's phenomena ka kya hota hai? If there is a patient is having, let's say, psoriasis, or usko right elbow pe lesion hai, and if the patient gets trauma to the left side of the hand, the new psoriatic lesion will develop there. That is called as the Cobner's phenomena. That is seen in mainly in psoriasis, can be seen in other conditions also. In the PSM, we have discussed about the epidemic dropsy. Epidemic dropsy is seen when the patient, if there is in the mustard oil, the mixed with the albumin oil, it will lead to epidemic dropsy. The patient will have ascites, will have the pedal edema. They have given the clinical scenario, but the hint was mustard oil was written in the question. Mustard oil, it is epidemic dropsy. Then just below to that, again you can see that coincidence that ki humne do statement padhe and they both were asked continuously in your exam. Relative risk is calculated in the cohort study. That was an easy straightforward question. Then there was a question from the protein energy malnutrition. The difference between the marasmus and Kwashiorkor, I told you it's very important. Kwashiorkor mein patient ko edema hoga, marasmus mein edema nahi hoga. You can see the image also I have shown you. So if the word edema was there, the answer was Kwashiorkor. Then we have discussed about the dysferoxamine. I already told you dysferoxamine is iron chelator. We have discussed twice in the class. Then we have discussed about myasthenia gravis. Myasthenia gravis se do question aaye the. It was type 2 hypersensitivity. Second, that they have given the clinical scenario or diagnosis pucha tha. And I told you that myasthenia gravis mein patient ko in the morning there is no symptom, but towards the end of the day there will be muscle weakness, fatigue, ptosis, diplopia that is going to develop. And they have given this very classical scenario. Subah mein koi problem nahi hai. Towards the evening the patient is having the symptom, that is myasthenia gravis. The next, we from the pharmacology, we have got a question on the smoking cessation. They have asked that there is a lady who wants to stop the smoking. For smoking cessation, the drug that can be used is the valencilin. Valencilin is the alpha 4 beta 2 agonist, partial agonist nicotine receptor that is used. Then there is a preferred mode of contraception during the lactation. They have given that the lady is in the lactating period, postpartum period. The preferred mode of contraception is the POP, progesterone only pills. Now some students are saying that ki usme pucha tha ki for long term contraception what is to be done. So again it's not clear whether this word is there or not. If it is there, then the answer is going to be different. If it's not there, it's just written postpartum, the contraceptive of choice is POPs. Then there was again the very famous question, again the soap bubble appearance. This time they have not given this image of wrist, they have given the image of the tibia, and almost the same image was there of the tibia, the soap bubble appearance that is seen in the giant cell tumor. Then the classical bamboo spine is seen in ankylosing spondylitis. Again it was an easy straightforward direct question. Then we have discussed few of the MCQs, the clinical MCQs from the biochemistry also, and one of the MCQ was straightforward, was asked in your exam. Ki patient ko, there is darkening of urine on standing, there is cartilage pigmentation, cartilage breakdown, onchronosis is there. Which enzyme is deficit? It is alkaptonuria, and I told you that it is due to deficiency of homogenitisate oxidase. The exact question we have discussed in the QRS. Then there was again very famous question, the castle necklace appearance is multiple times asked in your exam. Castle necklace is due to deficiency of vitamin B3. There was a question on neurotype defect. It has the multifactorial inheritance. Then there was a question on the bitot spot. Bitot spot, they have not given the image, but they have told you that there is white foamy conjunctiva. It is due to deficiency of which vitamin? It is vitamin A deficiency. Then there were two questions from pheochromocytoma, and both are there. You can see here both the description. One, there was a clinical diagnosis that you have to make. They told you that the patient is having profuse sweating, headache, palpitation, episodic. It's very classical for pheochromocytoma. The second, they ask that which investigation you will do. You will do 24-hour metanephrine levels, and we have written that you will check the metanephrine levels. They are going to be elevated. So I have what I want to conclude here is, in the QRS session which we had for almost 2.5 days, and we have almost tried to cover all the subjects in 2.5 days of the marathon, and out of that there was 51 direct question, which I have told you, 51 direct question, and there were many indirect question that was there. Although we and the students were not able to recall all the questions, so we cannot say the exact number, but it was very helpful. And as you can see that these are the screenshot of the class only that we had at RIS, and these are the questions that they have appeared almost as it is in the exam. In case the language may be different, but if anything is there, you can share to improve if there is any deviation was there in the language or the scheme of the question, right? Thank you guys.